What did you think of your wet welcome today?
Very good. I thought it was very nice coming out in all that rain.
Yeah, it was great.
Did you enjoy the rain?
Oh, yeah, well, well, funny standing there in your new coat.
Seeing as they got soaked, though, you know, we didn't mind, did
we? We'd like to pay a tribute for you coming on the open cut. In that cut round, because the kids have been waiting all night and they appreciate it.
Well, they deserved it, didn't they, waiting all night?
Yeah. I hope you were wearing drip-dry clothes, were you?
No, we just we thought it was going to be sunny.
George,
yeah, our case yeah. Gone
who selected
yet.
The name The Beatles and how did you derive this particular name? Was
well,
it B.A. instead
John
of Beatley?
Got the name Beatles
in a vision,
ages ago, you know, when we wanted, when we needed a name and everybody was thinking of a name and he thought of Beatles.
Why the B.E.A. instead of the B.E.?
Well, actually, you know,
if they left it with B-double-E, it was hard enough getting people to understand why it was B-E-A, never mind.
Paul, yeah. What do you expect to find here in Australia?
Australians.
Do you have any acknowledged leader of the group?
No, not really.
Paul,
we heard you stood on the balcony outside, is that right? Pardon? We heard you stood on your head on the balcony outside.
No, you don't have to hear some rumours.
You didn't stand on your head.
How did the tickets go in Hong Kong? Did you get full houses in?
I think so. No, there was a few 5 quid seats.
A few 5 quid left.
Five quid?
Yeah, they were a bit hot, weren't they?
I would have heard you.
I would have seen me in for 5 quid.
No,
did you?
I wouldn't.
I wouldn't say anything.
Have you for 2 bars?
John, has the Mersey beat changed since you've been playing it?
Oh, well, we still keep on saying there's no such thing as Mersey, just something the press made up, you know.
Well, we call it rock and roll. You play the same way now as you did?
Just rock and roll, just so happens we write most of it.
Has Buddy Holly influenced your music at all, Joe?
He did in the early days, obviously, you know. But, not obviously, but he was one of the greats, you know. So
did James Thurber, though, didn't he?
Oh, yeah, but he doesn't sing so well.
Have you been practising up your Australian accents?
No, Carl, not at all. We can't get it, you know.
You think you'll be writing any songs with Australian themes when you hear?
No, we never write themes about anything, you know. Just write the same rubbish all the time.
You play the kind of music you want to play or the kind of music you think people want to hear?
No, we've been playing this kind of music for about 5 or 6 years or something like that. It's just rock and roll, you know. It just happens we write it.
Well, what do you think made the difference that suddenly put you up above the other groups?
Well, we got a record contract.
Speaking of records, what record do you all agree on, generally, as your best recording? Not the best solo, but as the best recording musically.
You mean our favourite?
Mm-hmm. Well, we always like the one we just made, don't we? So it's Longshore Sally for me.
This is your latest one?
I like.
Well, it's quite new, you know.
I like.
It's not even the same.
Sorry. I like You Can't Do That.
What do you like, Jimmy?
What about you, Jim? You haven't said anything. How do you feel, Jimmy, being in with the Beatles?
Pardon?
How do you feel being in with the Beatles, a newcomer, standing in for Ringo?
It's a good experience, man.
How is Ringo?
He's much better. He joins them on Sunday.
What do you do then?
I go back to London and they're fixing up a band for me and I do some television.
And he's away?
You've been progressing pretty well with your Beatle haircut.
Yeah, well, I've been growing it for about 3 months.
But how long does it take to get a magnificent mane like this?
I don't know, I can't remember being without it.
Do you ever go to the barbers, John?
No, you know, I haven't had a haircut since the film, the woman on the film cut it good, but I don't trust anybody else.
Obviously. This is the film Beatlemania, is it?
No, it's not called that. That's another story.
Hard Day's Night,
it's called.
Are you satisfied with the finished product?
Well, it's as good as anybody that makes a film who can't act, you know.
Are you individually millionaires yet?
No, that's another lousy rumour, wouldn't it?
Brian Epstein, a millionaire.
No, even he's not one, poor fellow.
Where does all the money go?
Well, a lot of it goes to Her Majesty.
She's a millionaire.
Isn't it a bit disconcerting when you go on stage and do your numbers and all nobody hears them because all the girls are screaming?
Well, it's usually adults who don't hear them. You know, like in Hong Kong, in the paper it said, the Beatles fought a losing battle against the screams. Now, compared to other people, they were quite quiet, you know, they were still shouting. And most of the kids could hear it, but adults went out thinking, I couldn't hear a thing.
Are you very conscious of your responsibilities? I mean, teenagers dwell on your every comment and action. Do you feel very responsible towards this?
No, we just sort of behave as normally as we can, you know. We don't feel as though we should preach this and tell them that, you know, let them do what they like.
We never used to believe it when in the old days, we used to open a magazine and they'd say, so-and-so doesn't drink, doesn't smoke, doesn't go out late.
A bit of a sock,
we used to do it. A bit funny. So, I mean, we just act normally. and just hope that other people don't think we're a bit funny.
Now, you say you act normally, but how can you? How can you when you're getting so much money, when everywhere you go people are pressing around
normal,
and
they
can't see anything?
Well, you know, I mean, normal in the
environment. In the environment that surrounds you, like well, you're that's as normal as you
right.
can, don't you?
Correct.
But the original record, after about 8 years, coming back and topping the charts around the world.
Well, it hasn't topped the charts around the world yet.
I think it's sold a lot here, but I don't think it's selling very well. If it does, we're glad, because that's what we like rock and roll, you know, that all starts again, goody goody. And also you brought back in England, with the Beatles, the advent of the Beatles, people like Jerry Lee Lewis, and Little Richard have once again become big names, haven't they?
Yeah, but there were always groups of people who liked them, you know, especially in places like Liverpool. There were always staunch groups of fans who've never gone off people like that, Chuck Berry, Jerry Lee, Little Richard.
So you've more or less revived rock and roll?
Well, you know, revived interest in the beat music, that's all, really.
Yeah. How do you fellas feel about the sort of music that people like 10, 12, 15 years ago, Frank Sinatra, Ella Fitzgerald, this type of jazz? Do you like it, or do you only like rock and roll?
No, but that's not the point. You know, recently Ella Fitzgerald's done... Ella Fitzgerald did Can't Buy Me Love. Have you heard it?
Well, she did it like Ella Fitzgerald.
So, you know, it doesn't
do it like Frank Sinatra.
This would be a great compliment to your voice, wouldn't it?
Yeah, but I mean,
yeah.
You know what I mean?
It's,
you know, it doesn't necessarily have to be jazz, because it's one of our songs, you know, we don't reckon we write jazz.
What
she
like
sort of did it with the
jazz.
Yeah, it's nice.
You just don't only like the modern...
We like all kinds of music. You know, whatever appeals to us, if it's good music for us, and if
what?
Good, I don't know.
Got lost again.
Do you find much jealousy amongst other groups in England about you?
Not
come across it at all?
Not really, because most of the top groups out there are friends of ours, so there's none of that. You know, the jealousy is only something they mix up in the papers. You know, obviously they've got to keep the sort of thing going.
And then
all the groups that are anything over there are sort of best mates. Here, so.
And if any of them don't like us, then they don't sort of tell it to our faces anyway. We must just say it behind our backs.
What's your favourite entertainment medium? Would you like best theatre or television?
I like films.
Oh!
He's going straight.
He's included after the film.
No, you don't mean... You mean for us?
For the Beatles, yes.
Oh, I thought you meant for when we're watching, being entertained.
No,
well, I don't know, really. I think live shows are pretty good.
But they're all good because you get a change.
Yeah.
So that's the best thing again, you know, all of them together.
Is it true that you originally auditioned for two record companies before you were finally signed by EMI Records?
Yeah, we made tapes for Decca and I think...
And Pi.
But we didn't actually go to Pi.
In fact, EMI turned us down, first of all.
Yeah.
They did?
Yeah, first
oh,
of all.
you may laugh. But
don't blame him after hearing the tapes.
And then George Martin, he from EMI, he decided to sign us up just himself, you see.
I think I've got all the songs on.
How many records have you got any idea how many records you have sold? Around the world?
No, I have just a rough idea. I asked our publisher to give me an idea.
Last time I heard it was around about 30 million.
30 million?
Big, I don't understand.
Complaining, but you know, it's always raining.
Who has a Jaguar now? It's Paul, isn't it?
No, it's George.
George?
No.
Do you all read music?
I gave it a
no, no, none of us.
Comics, we're good at comics.
We're talking about how you do like to be entertained. How do you like to be entertained? What's your busting comedy?
Films, yeah. Shows, nightclubs, cabaret, and things like that.
And
you
go to a
cabaret with that.
Yeah.
Means mob.
Yeah.
Well,
don't
people cabaret. Don't walk around in mobs, you know.
Is it true you can go
outside?
I know, but I mean, if you go to a nightclub, you're not going to bump into 500 kids, are you?
This nightclub in Liverpool, the Blue Angel, is that a nightclub you can sort of go to and relax?
It was when we were up there a lot, you know. I don't know. A lot of places in Liverpool have got sort of...
Commercialised,
though people come from all over the place just have a look at them, you know, so I don't know now, I haven't been for years.
Have you played the Cavern at all lately?
I haven't played that for, I don't know.
Oh,
for
years. Yeah.
John, this might be a good one for you to answer. Did you people want to come to Australia?
So they're not booked completely without our knowledge. We're told that there's a possibility you might be going here or there, and if it wouldn't didn't like it, we'd say.
So you did want
to come. We said, yeah, because, you know, it's a place to go.
Well, great.
And what was your Darwin reception like, by the way?
Very cool. We didn't know.
Yeah, it was three in the morning, I think. And we didn't know until we got about an hour away from it.
But apparently the press in Darwin
known
all day.
Pounding. No, I think they guessed.
Only some fella said that the police had been trying to keep it quiet here all day.
Well, a BOAC spokesman said...
Advertising again.
..said that it wasn't definite, but there was a slight possibility.
He's been trying to get on it for hours.
Can I now? Fellas, did you enjoy doing the Shakespearean excerpt in your TV show?
Yeah. What? Except he made us rehearse for days.
Oh. And we still got it wrong.
Would you like to play legitimate Shakespeare?
Yeah.
Outstanding.
Did you like the costumes?
Yeah, they were good for laughs.
Mod.
This lantern doth the owner's moon present.
Yeah.
You've been liking the look of the Marx Brothers. Do you find us a couple? Do you dig this sort of thing?
It's a couple. Well, not for the half. Yeah, they're funny, aren't they?
When are you going to play the London Palladium?
Oh, we don't know.
Would you like to?
Oh, we've done it
a couple of times.
You know, I don't know nothing or anything about...
What's the group you play with in England, Jimmy?
Huh?
What's the group you play with in England?
Well, I played with a lot of groups in England. Just before I left, I was playing with a rhythm and blues band.
You were the Blue Flames, weren't you, Paul?
Yeah, that's right. Well, only for a matter of days. It's only till Friday. I only knew that I was doing this on Wednesday. You know.
Does but Brian Epstein manage you?
I don't really know.
No, he doesn't.
He doesn't,
yeah. I don't really know. You'd know it if he did.
Jimmy, what was your first reaction when you were told that you were going to play with the Beatles?
I couldn't believe it, really.
Did you have to rehearse to get their style?
No, we only rehearsed about five or six numbers, which took up an hour, and then...
And away you went.
Yeah.
If one of you stopped being the Beatles...
Pretty frightening?
The first show was very frightening, yeah. But, they reassured
me. But he did grand. He did
a grand job, he did that.
Grand
thanks,
job.
Lad.
George, if one of you stopped being a Beatle, what do you think you'd do?
I think I'd train elephants in the zoo.
That's quite
right. It's reported that you're the keen businessman of the group, is that right?
Well, yes, that's what he said in the paper. But, you know, I mean, I've never heard of him. There's a new one on me. And maybe, I don't know.
Do you have a contract to remain together as a group known as the Beatles? In other words, do you have contracts between yourselves?
Well, we've got a partnership.
There's some sort of
that's what you mean.
No, what I meant was
you mean personally,
could George suddenly decide to leave the Beatles group? Could you do that?
I think
he
could.
Well,
of course he could, because, I mean, we would stop him.
No, you know, he'd have to leave.
We'd have to keep him there. You know, struggling.
I think there is a contract.
I wanted to play.
There is a contract between the four of us, but if I wanted to leave, then they wouldn't try and stop me, or they wouldn't sue me, I don't think. Would you, fellas?
Apparently you earn many, many thousands of pounds a year, but how much money do you actually get to spend from your manager?
Well, we don't get money from him, we get money from our accountant, you know. All our money goes to him.
Are you on a regular basis?
Yeah, well, we don't hardly need anything, you know, because most things are... sort of paid through the company, you know. We just hardly spend anything in cash, just cigarettes and things, and even that, they bought by our road managers. Thing, you know.
We get a certain amount a week, and we've got at least half of it left.
What about clothing? Does it also come from the accountant too?
Well, sometimes.
Yeah, well, usually we get our tailor to, you know, we order a few suits or how many we want, and then he'll send the bill into the company. Because it's much easier for him to do that as well, and it's easier for us.
Well, he got two suits.
This leads me to the next question. Now, on stage, you all dress literally the same, but off stage, I notice even here that you're all dressed quite different. Now, is this also something you make up yourselves? Or?
No, you go on. I mean, originally we didn't dress.
Who decided you to change from leather suits to natty suits?
He tried to persuade us.
Because when we went down south, it was all right in Liverpool around there, but as soon as we went anywhere else in sort of jeans and leather jackets, they sort of didn't want to know, you know, because they wanted everybody in grey suits doing that.
You single chaps really don't have any firm plans to get married in the next
year? No, I don't like the idea of marriage. It's a bit frightening.
Why is that?
It is, isn't it?
And we're all trying to save up a bit before we get
married. Did you enjoy your holidays to Tahiti and the Caribbean, wasn't it?
Yeah,
we met one of your...
Some fella came swimming behind me saying, "You're having a good time," didn't he?
Yeah.
Saying, "I've come all the way from Sydney."
Yeah, as if it was my fault.
Why did you split up and take your holidays?
Like? People like them.
It makes it harder for people with the press to catch us up. Before. If we all got together, it's a cinch, you know, going to an airport.
And anyway, besides all that, Paul and Ringo fancied going to wherever they went.
Didn't you ask him something about Liverpool, though? That wasn't the question, was it?
Well, you coming from Liverpool, what sort of idea do people in Liverpool have about Australia?
Sorry, he was right.
There's a theory that you're almost as popular with adults as you are with teenagers, and that when teenagers find this out, that they will probably lose interest in you. Do you think
that's true? Maybe. No, I'm not saying a word. I don't know. What do you think?
A couple of photographs recently came from America showing all of you, I think it was George and Paul, the one I saw, swimming, but both photographs in different places showed you with shirts on. Now, is this a regular thing to swim with a shirt on?
I think we were only posing for the press and we weren't really swimming.
Oh, I see.
We were just moving about in like 2 inches of water.
Only we were actually swimming, as it were, with shirts. Right. Because we always wear overcoats when we're swimming.
White skins with sometimes.
John, what do you attribute to something like Bill Haley's Rock Around the Clock, the original record, after about 8 years coming back and topping the charts around the world?
Well, it hasn't topped the charts around the world yet, has it?
Well, I think it's sold a lot here. I doubt, I don't think it's selling very well.
If it does, we're glad. We like rock and roll, you know. That whole stuff again, pretty good.
And also, you brought back in England with the Beatles, the advent of the Beatles, people like Jerry Lee Lewis and Little Richard have once again become big names, haven't they?
Yeah, but there were always groups of people who liked them. You know, especially in places like Liverpool, there were always staunch groups of fans who never.
And I don't know what happened to us. Somebody just gave us the ticket. And we just ended up there.
When Jerry and the Pacemakers were out here, they rubbished Australian beer. If you had a go at Australian beer, you'd be trying
to. I'm not keen on beer.
I don't like any beer, really.
What do you like?
Scotch and Coke.
Teenage
stuff.
Is
that a drink that's drunk a lot in England?
No,
I don't know.
We got in Germany because we didn't like German beer.
Apparently the real one's rum and coke. That's the one that everyone knows.
Oh, yeah.
But someone gave us Scotch and
coke. They all drink it in Tahiti, we found out.
Oh, yeah.
That's their sort of normal drink.
What, Scotch and coke? But it's called Scotch and coke.
When you work, is it true that you have a lot of coke backstage and drink a lot of coke while you work?
Well, you know, just cold drinks. I mean, if it happens to be lemonade, it doesn't matter.
How do you feel before a show? Do you feel nervous?
Yeah.
Depends on the show, where it is and what it is.
How big it is.
Yeah.
Well, it's just a new place.
You know, even if it can be a small show and a very new place, and you still get very nervous. You get nervous on the most ridiculous of things, too. The Merseybeat Awards. Remember about, we got an award from a Liverpool paper, the Merseybeat. And, you know, it was only quite a small thing, the award giving, compared to some of the big shows we've been doing, but we were all nervous.
Well, apart from its value to your act, do you like Derek O'Hale as well?
Yeah, well, we've had it a long time, and we've got used to it. It's like a, you know, the native when it was being really quick.
And it's not as though somebody made us wear it like this. No, we had it like this before we started making records. Didn't we?
Why? Economy?
Pardon?
No, I mean, it
just happened.
Stupid way people can be so odd. I mean, it's only since the First World War, I read, the oil went around like that, because he's cutting the biddies out from the trenches, that's what I read. Before then, you all had it long.
That's right, Paul.
Don't believe it. I do.
Sure enough, but I
not my dad. It's a good excuse.
Not my dad. My dad's got no biddies. No, we haven't.
Which one? Your dad's a bus driver, isn't he, George?
Well, he was.
Got a gold plated horse.
What do your family think about all the attention, Jack?
Well, naturally they like it, and they're all proud, and, you know, just like if you had a son, what with a Beatle, or even if you didn't, you're bound to like it more than the other
girls.
You do
get together,
isn't it? Yeah.
All fellows who work very close together so often and stay and travel together, you must have an occasional argument. So how do you work it out in your system apart from going away on holiday?
Well, it's usually two against one or three against one.
We never have a serious argument.
Or whoever can shout loudest.
Another one. It's
reported that the Rolling Stones are the biggest.
Well, it's untrue.
Sometimes I'm losing our report.
Oh, yeah.
Dave Clark was bigger than us last.
They're big,
last
you know.
And Brian Poole the month before.
Records and things like that. It's true, but, yeah, they're not big enough for the big. And that's the truth.
But they wouldn't have the teenage crowds gathering wherever they appeared, the two boys would.
Well,
you
know, they're big followers.
They're very popular.
This all harks back. Don't make us release as many singles. I mean, a lot of people say the Beatles are slipping because their record's number 15, but they forget it's already fell about 3 minutes.
Yeah, I mean, but that happened with our second record. No, the third one from ECU, you know, because it sold more than three seasons and it went out quicker or something like that. Everyone said, oh, that's it then, you know. And they've done it, every single we've made, left it, you know, so you just give up.
Yeah, and also, the thing about the record now is that they have an awful lot of advance. Is it?
Paul
speak. Okay. They have a lot of advance sales. So they come in the first week very high and then sell for about 2 weeks. And they've got to go out very quickly. They've sold an awful lot of records, but it's still, to people who don't know about the record business, it looks a bit off, you know, and I think.
Did you read the comments that Hal Wallace, the American producer who produces all Presley's films, said about you in a recent
film? No, what did he say?
Interview. He sort of referred to you as four untalented men, you know, shaggy sort of creatures.
Noel Coward said that.
Noel Coward said
that. Wonder if they know each other.
Would you look upon this as jealousy, mainly because
you're
an American, because you're not American?
No, it's basically, you know, to some people, we've got nothing.
It would be useless for everybody to like. You've got to have somebody knocking you up. Those people say, oh, what's he knocking them for? They're all right, aren't they? You know, it's good when people knock you up.
It doesn't matter, you know, there's nobody that everybody likes.
You've got a lot of songs up your sleeve that you haven't recorded, haven't been published, quite literally. But you still keep writing songs, that's the thing?
Yeah.
Enough supply
No, but the old songs, you know, most of them aren't very good anyway. You know, they were when we were really starting off. One or two, Love Me Do was an old song. Yeah.
Do you have any individual ambitions to be more than a member of the singing group of the Beatles,
Alfred? No.
It's enough.
How many people travel with you, Ricky?
Depends where we're going.
Three.
Now we've got three people. We've got a fellow who looks after the equipment, then our road manager, and then we've got Mr. Epstein's personal assistant here, Derek Taylor.
Correct.
That's
correct.
In there.
Correct, Derek.
Yes,
correct.
He's
and,
does anybody advise you about what sort of song to record or to release?
No.
Our A&R man advises when we've made, say, two tracks, he advises us as to which is the more. But it's normally we agree amongst ourselves.
And have George and Ringo ever tried to compose songs?
Yeah. George has
written. I thought it was always Paul and John.
Well, it is. They've written every song we've ever recorded except one. Epstein's.
I thought it was always Paul and John.
Well, it is. They've written every song we've ever recorded except one. And I wrote that one.
When Brian Epstein took over managing you, how did he first promote you? How did he first start promoting you?
Well, when he first started handling us, he wasn't a manager, you know, in show business. He was a director of his father's business.
Come here, fellas, one last question.
So anyway, I'll tell you later.
One last question. Do you enjoy being the Beatles, the Beatles, as much as you did, say, a couple of years ago?
Yeah.
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 It's
different. It's a different way, of course, but still not.
Well, that just about sums it up. Big stand at the end of our telecast, which was inside, but it's usually the dining room.
Like Alan will be in it.
Sheraton Hotel, right opposite the
bye, everybody.
And we'll say a very good afternoon.
Goodbye. Ta-da.
Are these all recordings, or are they live?
Record on air,
some are filmed, and some are...
Oh, yeah, that's
good. Hello, Trinidad American. Very well, gentlemen.
Yeah.